Good morning, parents. Welcome to DMIS Parent Orientation Program. This orientation is both for the parents as well as students. Thank you for choosing DMIS as a school for your ward. This is a very short presentation. This makes you familiar with the school chores, how we are going to operate from the registration side, from the transport side, from the finance side, these things. Before I start, let me give you a little bit about our school information. Doha Modern Indian School, established in 2005, is one of the five schools under the Talib banner. Under the Talib banner, we have five schools. Three international schools with the UK curriculum, one IB curriculum school, and one the DMIS, that is the Indian curriculum school. The school affiliated to CBSE, New Delhi, which offers the national curriculum and prepares the students for All India Senior School Certificate Examination when they go to grade 12. This is our simple mission statement. DMIS creates nurture, happy, creative, moral citizens who live motivated, fulfilled lives while enriching the lives of others. It encourages learners to develop their individual talents, critical thinking, and technological skills to be the global citizens. Provide a joyful, safe, caring, and disciplined environment that promotes growth in wisdom, knowledge, and responsible freedom. The school aims to foster in the students humility and confidence, compassion and ambition, respect and curiosity, tolerance and vision, flair and discipline, academic rigor. So these are the objectives of DMIS. We believe in collaboration of parent, teacher, and student. In order to nurture the student, definitely we, as a family, we should work together. So we support from the school front, and we expect the same thing from the parent side. What will be the role of the teachers? They plan the curriculum, yearly curriculum, monthly curriculum, and the daily curriculum. So you can see the complete planning on the parent portal. Syllabus completion. So before the exams, it is the teacher's responsibility to have the proper revision for the exam, then the exam week starts. Remedial teaching. In case, if the students fall short of expectation, there will be the remedial session for the students. Revision classes. Communication with parents for issues of immediate concern. In case if your ward is absent for more than 3 days, in case if your ward is not performing well, the teachers will communicate through PRO. Role of parents. Attend parent-teacher meeting for regular updates of your ward's performance. So whenever we call the parent for the parent-teacher meeting, please present for the meeting. Check the mails and the messages regularly. We send the SMS for all our updates. If anything happens in the school, if any information wants to communicate to the parent, so we send the SMS. Please check your SMS regularly. Any notice sent from the school to be acknowledged. Be present for the meeting called. Check the student planner, weekly gazette on a regular basis. So this is the first mode of communication. If you want to communicate anything to the teacher, please send a note in the planner. Ask your ward to show it to the teacher. Check our weekly gazette for all the photos, for all the information. So you will come to know what's happening in the school. Ensure that your ward is regular in submitting the assignments, projects on time to the concerned teacher. Parents are requested to update their contact number and email with the registration department immediately in case of any change. If you don't update, you will not get the SMS and you will not receive an email from the school. Please ensure your contact details are updated in the registrar's department. Parents work with the teachers to achieve a common goal for betterment of a child. What is the role of the student? 80% attendance is mandatory as per the CBSE norms. We are expecting the student to submit their assignments, activities on time. School rules and code of conduct is very, very important. So DMIS is a highly disciplined school. So we expect the complete DMIS fraternity that includes the DMIS staff, DMIS student, DMIS parents to follow our rules and the code of conduct. School timings. Here, just I have mentioned the school timings during the COVID situation. KG starts at 8:30 to 11 a.m. Grades 1 to 8 starts from 7 a.m. to 11 a.m. Grades 9 to 12 from 7 a.m. to 1 p.m. This timings is applicable only during the COVID time. Students must be punctual and attend the school regularly. On transport students, so the parents picking up the child, it is the parents' responsibility to pick them on time. Periodic test examinations. So students are going to have the periodic test, half-yearly examination, pre-board examination for grade 10 and 12, and the annual examination. Please check the student's planner carefully for the dates. So you can plan your vacation based on these things. Attendance is mandatory for all the exams. Pre-tests. In case, if the student misses the test or the examinations, so we will not give the retest. Average will be given in case of medical leave with approved medical certificate or a student is representing the school for activities. If I use the word retest, it will be only at the end of the year for the failed students. Retest will not be conducted for the test or for the exams. This is the DMIS way. School-wide expectations. Be respectful. Follow the school instructions carefully. Speak and work appropriately. Be on time for your lesson. Be an engaged learner. We believe in partnership. Students, parents, teachers, administration forms the DMIS team. Repeated offenses from the student front. There will be a detention. If it's more, suspension from the extracurricular activities and field trips. If it's beyond the limit, the student will be suspended from the school. What is our school code of conduct? Student must be punctual. Complete well-ironed uniform is very much required. ID card is mandatory. Long nails, tattoos, jewelry, makeup strictly prohibited. Boys to have a decent haircut. Electronic devices not permitted to school. Cell phone, iPods, iPads, digital watches. In case, if the student has a cell phone, so they'll have to submit it to the PRO before going to the classes. After the school hours, while going home, they can collect the same from the PRO. Bullying. What is bullying? It may involve, but not limited to, repeated teasing, social exclusion, threats, intimidation, stalking, physical violence, religious or racial harassment, or public humiliation. A student who feels he or she is a victim of bullying, threats, or witnesses action viewed as bullying should report to the school PRO immediately. School communication. We communicated to the parent in different ways. You also can do the same thing. You can call the PRO, you can send us an email, check our school website, check our Facebook, parent portal, parent-teacher meeting, weekly gazettes, student planner. So these are the different ways where we can communicate. But dear parents, communicating to the teachers directly is strictly prohibited at DMIS. Please ensure any ways of communication, it has to go through the PRO. If you want to make a phone call to the PRO, if you want to send an email, please send it to the PRO. Whereas the planner, you can address it to the teacher. Medications. Students are not allowing to bring or to be in possession of any type of medication. All medication, including the prescriptions and over-the-counter medication, should be delivered to the nurse clinic, either by a parent or by a legal guardian, in the original containers with proper labeling indicating the names, dosage, and time. Blended learning. What is blended learning? During the COVID time, the school is giving the blended learning. Blended learning is a combination of both online and offline education. KG grades 3 to 9. Each student is coming to school in a week twice. We are dividing the classes into two groups, roll number 15, group 1, and 16 to 13, group 2. When group 1 is attending the school, group 2 is going to have their lesson through Zoom in the second session, that is after 11 a.m. and vice versa. Students with chronic illness and approved medical certificates can join the Zoom lessons where attendance will be given. For other students who fail to attend the regular classes and join the Zoom, attendance will not be provided. Grades 1 and 2, entire grade will come to school on specified days as per the timetable. Dear parents, you will receive the timetable within the next 2 to 3 days. Definitely before 3rd, we are going to upload the timetable on the parent portal and the safe plan on the parent portal. So you can look into those things. Zoom etiquette. When a student joins the Zoom lesson, there are certain code of conduct rules they will have to follow. Students are expected not to mute their microphones and not to turn on their cameras till the end of the session. So the student's camera should be on till the end of the lesson. The microphone, the teacher will guide them whether to mute the microphone or not to mute the microphone. Students are advised to sit unaccompanied for effective and easy gauge from our end. Parents, as far as possible, please do not sit with your ward. Do not prompt. Maybe KG grade 1 and 2, yes, the parents are advised to sit, but not for the higher grades. Parents will ensure decorum in the room is conducive for studies. Do not encourage the students to call or answer the mobiles during the lesson. During the lesson, having food, using the mobile, going to the toilet is strictly prohibited. In case if the student wants to use a washroom, they will have to take the teacher's permission. If the student is not on the screen for 2 to 3 minutes, the students will be out from the class. During the break time, students should turn off from their cameras and their microphones should be muted. Before the Zoom lessons, students should be ready with their notebooks, textbooks, and other resources required for the lessons. Dress code, school uniform. Parents or students to strictly follow the mode of learning they have opted. Please, in case if your student has opted, for example, if a student is supposed to come to school on Sunday, we expect the student to come to school on Sunday. They cannot do whatever they want. Oh, today I'm not interested to go to school. Let me join the Zoom lesson. Even though we allow them, but attendance will not be provided. Any technical issues from the school front, please contact the PRO. If any technical issues at the home front, school is not responsible. Textbooks, copy book, and planner. You will receive an SMS from the school front when it is ready for collection. definitely before the next weekend, we should be in a position to collect all these things. Dear parents and students, we are looking forward to a successful 21-22 school year. Please let us know how we can help your student to have the best possible experience. Together, we will always succeed. For any information from the school front, please call the PRO or you can send us an email, pro@dmisqatar.com. Thank you. Have a safe day and a good day.
Dear parents, good morning and welcome to the team of DMIS. My name is Bayram and I'm the head of registration department. First, I wanted to thank you for choosing DMIS for your words. And I hope that this academic year 2021-22 will be a successful academic year for all our students. Please know that along with the registration process that we made, we as a registration office and you as parent to admit your child in our school, registration department also has other roles and other tasks. We do provide to parents certificates such as vacancy letters. Normally vacancy letters are requested by the previous school of your children. So please, if you have any vacancy letter request, don't hesitate to send me an email. The request for the same. We do provide also bona fide certificates, study certificates, report cards by the end of half yearly one, and the final examination also, school leaving certificate for student who will be relocating to home country or changing the school, and CBSE certificate for grade 10 and grade 12. We do also accept edit requests from parents. For any parent or student who has a mistake in the name or the residence permit number, passport number, or date of birth, please send me an email with the correct information and we will make the edit. Address, phone numbers, if you will change your email address, all of those requests, you will just have to send one email to registration department and we will do the needful. Thank you so much. And please, for all your inquiries, you may contact us on a registrar, address@dmisqatar.com or 555-32478. I leave you now with my colleague from finance department to speak to you about the finance procedures.
Good morning, everyone. A warm welcome to Finance Department and Doha Modern Dame School. My name is Nasif. I'll be taking care of all financial matters related to parents, like fees payment, reimbursement invoice, refund, etc. And I'll just explain you a brief about our school fees, which is mainly of tuition fee, which will be collected as three terms, and due dates are March 15, August 15 for the term two, and December 15 for the third term. These apart from this, you need to pay book fees for the first term, and transport fee, which is optional if it is required by the parents. You need to contact with the transport officer after registering. You can pay it finance department with cash counter. And this fees payment notification will be sent to your registered mobile number 30 days before the due dates, and you will get a reminder notice also in due time. Mode of payment will be cash or check at fees counter, and you have an option for online bank transfer to our Rahi Bank. The bank details will be provided once you contact through us on email or WhatsApp, and the receipts will be emailed for the bank transfer parents. And if you need a hard copy, you can come to cash counter, and cashier will help you for the hard copies. And you can contact during the school hours on our mobile number 5589600005. And the landline number 4445831, and my email ID is finance@dmskatar.com. Thank you for this live, and Mr. Muhammad, our transport officer, will describe about his department. Thank you for all for listening to me.
Transport and Security Service of DMIS. I'm Muhammad Siddiq, Transport and Security Officer. Good morning, parents. We are starting our new academic year for first week of April 2021. Parents who have registered their wards for school transport, we will help you understand to know how the system works. You might have several queries regarding transport. I will clear all the points. Hope you all will get your answers by the end of this presentation. Before school start, transport staff will visit your home according to the given address, and they will give you time for pickup and drop off. Transport will start from first day for all grades, from KG to grade 12. In every buses, we have conductor to take care of students. Regular attendance is being taken in the bus. After bus has arrived in the school, there is security check for all buses. And conductor will take all junior classes students to their class. After school gets over, conductor will collect them from their respective class. All parents are requested to adhere to give them due time by the conductor. Bus will not wait more than 3 minutes at the particular stop. Own transport parents will drop their ward in the porta cabin from first day of school. Our staff will take them to their respective class. And after school gets over, parents are supposed to collect their wards from porta cabin. If any queries, can contact through email or mobile, transport@dmskatar.com. And mobile number is 6600-3865. Hope all the points you might get all the answers in my points. Thank you.
Good morning, all parents. My name is Subin, working as an IT support in Doha Modern Indian School. Today, I will give you the short explanation about our portal, how the portal works, and how you can check the homework, how you can access the assignment, school circular, all those things. For accessing the portal, you need to type the portal address in the browser, any of the browser like the Google Chrome or the Edge. The portal address is talib-dmis.ethdigitalcampus.com. Once you type the address, you will be getting a web page where you have to enter the parent ID and the password. Parent ID will be starting from P and then the 5-digit number. In any of the cases, if you do not remember your parent ID, kindly refer to the fee receipt. Parent ID would be mentioned in the fee receipt. You can see that parent ID is starting from P and then 5-digit number. You have to type this as a login ID. And some of the cases, you may not be able to remember a password. There is an option for the reset password on the front page of the portal. Here you can see the option for the reset password. Just click on this link. Once you click on this link, here you have to type the login ID, which is starting from P and then the number. You have to type the mobile number with the country code, that is +974 and then the country code. Then you just click on the send. You will be getting an OTP. You will be getting an OTP in your mobile number. You have to verify that OTP. Once you verify that OTP, you will be getting the option to change the password. You have to set your own password. Once everything is done, you have to type the login name and the password, and you need to click on the login. So on the successful login, you would be redirected to the dashboard. Dashboard of the parent portal consists of a multiple tiles, including the respective information. Clicking on the specific tile will redirect you to the respective page. On the front page of the parent portal, you can see the different tiles called the student profile, the school calendar, circular, assignment, all those things. When the parent click on the student picture available in the tile, the parent would be able to see the screen shown below. Here you can see the student profile, attendance report, report card, syllabus plan, medical history, LMS, transportation details, homeworks, and all. First, we will check about the homework. Click on the homework link to submit the homework. And here you can see the submission status. There are different submission statuses there: pending, submitted, and not submitted on time. Submit and can view the pending. And if you select the pending one, you can see whatever the pending homework is there. If you select the pending as a submission status, you will get the list of valid homework which are pending. If you want to submit any of the homework, there is an option just below the action tab. You can see the submit homework. You need to click on the submit homework. Once you click the submit homework link, click on the browse to select the file. You might have saved your file in your computer or your pen drive, or you just have to click on browse. Now you have to select the file. You can select multiple files, and please make sure that those multiple files should be saved in the same folder name. Any file format is accepted, like the picture, PDF, or the Word format. You have to select the file and click on open. After browsing the file, click on the submit button. And you will get a dialog box whether are you sure wanted to submit this assignment. Just click on OK button to confirm. You will find the successful message as shown below, like assignment submitted successfully. After successful submission of homework, you can view the uploaded homework and also have the option to delete the homework, which is shown below. In any cases, if you feel that you have inserted the wrong assignment or the wrong file, there is an option to remove the file. If you want to delete a particular file, click on click to remove and click on submit button, and you will receive a successful message. Now we will check the submission status as submitted. If you select submitted as submission status, you will get the list of valid homework where you can view or edit the homework. There is an option for view or edit submission. If you just click on that view or edit submission, once you select the view or edit submission, and you will get the below screen, and you can add or delete the file and click on submit button after making the necessary changes. Please note that once the submission date is over, you will not be able to view or edit a homework. So please make sure that you are submitting all the assignment on or before the date. Once the date is over, you will not be able to do anything. Now we will check the submission status as not submitted on time. If you select the status as not submitted on time, you will get the list of not submitted homework where the submission date is over and you will not be able to view or edit the homework. On the front page itself, you can see the tile named as academic details. When you click on this, you can view the assignment and syllabus plan according to the subject. You have to just click on the academic details tab. Once you click on the academic details tab, you can see the assignment and syllabus plan. Click on the respective subject and view or download the assignment and syllabus plan. Once you click on the assignment or the syllabus plan, here you can see the subject list. If you want to view any of the subject assignment like English or the mathematics, you just have to click on the subject title and you can view or download the assignment. Now in the school portal, in the front page itself, there is a school calendar. Once you click on this, you can view the month-wise calendar. There is an option for viewing the news. This title is to display the school related news. Whatever the school, whatever the news is uploaded from the school, you can just view by clicking on this link. Now, there is an option for viewing the circular. This title display to the circular uploaded by the school and you can view or the download and attachment if any. Normally, the circular will be uploaded in this tab. Here you can see the different circulars like any information related circular or the weekly gazette and all. There is an option for viewing the email. Whatever the email sent from the school, you can view all those emails from this email tab. Whatever the SMS you have received in your mobile, all those detailed SMS can be viewed in the parent portal also by clicking on the SMS tile. Now we will check how to log in into the Zoom online class. When you click on the student profile, there is an option for the LMS module. You just need to click the LMS module. Once you click on the LMS, you can see the Zoom schedule on the right side. Here you can see the whatever the Zoom is scheduled for the upcoming one. You just need to click on that, whatever the title like for the Zoom meeting, 29th March English, here you can see. So you just need to click on that Zoom meeting. And you can see there is a button called Join Meeting. You just need to click on the Join Meeting. If the Zoom client is already installed in your computer, it will straight away the Zoom client is open. And once the teacher is accepted the invitation, you can join into the meeting. Now we will check about the parent mobile application. In the Apple App Store or the Google Play Store, you just have to type Digital Campus Parent version 3. Please note that you have to type Digital Campus Parent V3. Once you type, just install the application. And after the installation, you will find the below application called DC Parent in your mobile. Once you click on that application, it will be asking you the school code. Please make note that our school code is DMIS. You have to type the school code on the front page. Once you click on the school code, just click on submit. And the system will be asking the username and password. The username and password will be same as the web user interface. You have to type the username, which is starting from the P, and then your password. Just click on the login. After entering the login credential, it will redirect to the home page where you will be able to see the student profile. Click on the student profile and you will be able to see the different tab as illustrated below. Here you can see the different options like email, SMS, news, homework, assignment. Whatever the things you have seen on the web interface, the same is replicated in the application also. If you want to view the notification, you can click on the notification icon as shown below. You just need to click on the notification icon. And in any cases, if you are not receiving any notification, you can click on the reset option as shown below. Once you click on the notification, this feature allows to view the email. Like if you click on the notification and if you have any notification about the email, you can see that email. You just click on it to click on the email. And if there is an attachment, click on the particular mail and also you can download the file. Once you click on the SMS, this option allows to view any SMS sent from the school. News. This option enables us to view any news published by the school and you can click to see detailed description with attachment if any. There is an option for viewing the circular. This helps to view the circular published by the school and also you can find any attachment. Homework. This option is to view the class homework sent by the school. Submission of the homework can happen from the mobile app as well as with just few simple steps. Click on the homework link. It will take you to the screen where by default all the pending homework to be submitted will be shown. Click on the document to download the homework and complete the homework. Once the homework is completed, come to the same screen and click on submit. After clicking on submit, parent would get option to browse the completed file by clicking the picture or uploading the document by clicking on the browse button. If you click on the browse button, there is a different option like straight away you can upload the file or you can use your phone camera and you can upload the file. You have to select the appropriate option according to you. Once the document is uploaded, it will shown as shown below. Here you can see the file path. That means you have selected the file and click on submit. Now we will check about the assignment. This option is to view the class assignment sent by the school. You can click on each subject-wise assignment and download the attachment. Once you click on the assignment, you can see the different subject. For example, if you want to view the any of the science assignment, just click on the science and then you will get the different title about the assignment and you can download the file. There is an option for viewing the attendance. This is to view the day-wise, class-wise attendance and you can also see whether the student is absent or present for a particular date. It also displays the holidays, if any, in the calendar. Now here you can see the school website option. Once you click on the school website, it will redirect you to the school website where you can see all the latest information and all. Thank you.
Dear parents, thank you for watching. Please ensure your child will follow the COVID protocols. Wearing the mask in the school is compulsory. Resources, pen, pencil, books, we will not allow them to share. Water bottle, snack box, lunch box, please ensure your ward will bring. Vending machine in the school is not working. So your child will not get anything from the school. Please ensure he will have enough water for the whole day. If your ward is chronically ill, please send a certificate to the PRO wherein he will be allowed to attend the lessons through Zoom. Stay safe, stay blessed, have a good day.